Hello everyone, this is Vishwanath Chavan, Assistant Professor, Computer Science and Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now I am here to explain the differences between the microprocessor 8085 and 8086. At the end of this session, the students will be able to differentiate the 8085 and 8086 architecture. Let us see how microprocessor age. Initially, in the year 1971, 4004 microprocessor is introduced, whose data size is 4 and memory size 4096. Later on in 73, 8008 is introduced, whose data size is 8 and supports for memory size 14 KB. Then in the same year, two more 8008 MC6800 were introduced with 8 bit and 64 KB. And later on in 1977, microprocessor 8085 is introduced. It has 8-bit data bus and it supports for 64 KB of memory. Then in the next year, 1978, 8086 is introduced, whose data size is 16-bit and it supports for 1 MB of memory. And in this 1979, 8088 is introduced, whose data size is 16-bit and supports for 1 MB of memory. And in 1983, 80286 is introduced, data size 16 and memory size 16 MB. In 86, 80386 is introduced, and in 89, 80486 is introduced. In 93, Pentium is introduced. So all these three are having data size 32-bit and memory size 4 GB. And in 93, Pentium is introduced, 32-bit data, 4 GB of memory. And in 95, Pentium Pro, and data size is 64 and 64 GB memory is supported. So this is about the microprocessor H. Now we'll see more detail about differences between 85 and 86 microprocessor. The first point regarding architecture. Now 8085 supports as a RISC, reduced instruction set computer, and 8086 is a CISC, complex instruction set computer. We'll see more detail after this slide. Next, second point regarding pipeline. 85 does not support for pipeline concept, but 8086 supports for pipeline concept. So regarding data bus, microprocessor 85 has 8-bit data bus and 86 has 16-bit. Regarding address bus, 8085 supports 16-bit address bus and 8086 supports for 20-bit address bus. And regarding memory, it supports for 64 KB and it supports for 1 MB. Then next point regarding instruction queue. So it does not have, but 86 it has instruction queue, whose length is 6 bytes. So regarding next point, multiprocessing, 85 does not support for multiprocessing concept, but 86 supports for multiprocessing concept. So regarding flags, 85 supports 5 different flags and 86 supports 9 different flags. Now the next point regarding input output. So 8085 supports for 256 I/O devices, since it has 8-bit data lines, 2 raised to 8, 256. And this is having 16 data lines and 20 address lines. It supports for 6, 5, 5, 3, 6 different I/O devices. Next point regarding arithmetic support. So it supports for integer and decimal. It supports for integer, decimal and ASCII. Next, multiplication and division. So 85 does not have multiplication and division instructions. It performs multiplication by successive addition and division by successive subtraction. But 86 supports for multiplication and division instructions. Next, regarding operating modes, it operates in single mode, but 8086 operates in two different modes, minimum and maximum mode. Now, regarding external hardware, 85 requires less external hardware, while 86 requires more external hardware. Next, regarding cost, 85 is available at low cost. 86 is available at high cost. Next point regarding segmentation. So it does not support for segmentation, but 86 supports for segmentation. There are four different segmentations: core segment, data segment, extra segment and stack segment. Now we'll see more detail regarding differences. Now CISC stands complex instruction set computer. So 8086 supports for CISC. Now it refers to number of complexity of instructions. The improvement was done with respect to 85. Now it supports for multiply and divide instruction. The number of instructions increased from 25, which is about 4004 processor, to 246. Which is of 8085, and 20,000, which is with respect to 86 or 8088 microprocessor. Now a RISC, it stands reduced instruction set computer. So 8085 falls under this, to execute one instruction per clock, since it does not support for pipeline concept. Think about this question and try to write the answer. The question is, how many data and address lines are present in 8085 and 8086? Pause this video and write down the answer. I hope you have answered. The answer is 8085 supports 8 data lines and 16 address lines, and 8086 supports 16 data lines and 20 address lines. So next concept regarding pipeline. So there are two ways to make CPU processor information make faster. The first one is increasing the working frequency, and second one is to change the internal architecture of CPU itself. Now, the pipelining is to allow CPU to fetch and execute at the same time. We'll see with example. So this is non-pipelined microprocessor, that is 8085. Since it is not a non-pipelined processor, it fetches in first clock cycle, next it executes. So it requires 2 cycles to fetch and execute the first instruction. Similarly for second, fetch and execute. But the pipeline processor, which is 8086, which fetches the first instruction in first clock cycle, in second clock cycle it executes. Meanwhile, during second clock cycle it fetches second instruction. It does not happen in non-pipeline. Similarly, in third clock cycle it executes second and it fetches third instruction. So at the end of fourth clock cycle, so execution of third instruction is available. So regarding registers. So 85 has 8-bit registers like A, B, C, D, H, L. But 8-bit registers in 86 are like AH, AL, BH, BL, CH, CL, DH, DL. But by having a combination of AH and AL, which leads 16-bit register in 86H, AX, similarly BX, CX, DX, SP, BP, SI, DI. And in higher version microprocessor, we'll find 32-bit registers which are extended as EAX, EBX, ECX, EDX, ESP, EBP, ESI, EDI. So these are the references. Thank you.